don't believe in fairy tales. I guess I've outgrown them. But that doesn't mean that I don't believe that there's something bigger than me. 'Cause I've seen it in a hospital room when the doctor said sorry. There's nothing more we can do. Well, it wasn't through. I've never seen a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. But I've got a promise I can hold in the middle of the struggle. God, if you said it, you'll perform it. May not be how I want you to, but here's what I'll do. I'm gonna wait on you. I'm gonna wait on you. I've tasted your goodness. I'm trusting your promise. I'm gonna wait on you. Yes, I'm gonna wait on you. Yeah. I've tasted your goodness. I'm trusting your promise. I'm gonna wait on you. Every step, yeah, you are the author, but there's no predicting what is next. But you hold the future, and all the questions, they come second to the one I know is true, yeah. Well, you've always been true, so I'm gonna wait on.
I set out on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road. But I got lost a time or two, wiped my brow and kept pushing through. I couldn't see how every sign pointed straight to you. That every long lost dream led me to where you are. Others who broke my heart, they were like northern stars, pointing me on my way into your loving arms. This much I know is true, that God bless the broken road that led me straight to you. Yes, it did. I think about the years I spent just passing through. I'd like to have the time I lost and give it back.
I was standing all alone against the world outside. You were searching for a place to hide. Lost and lonely, now you've given me the will to survive. When we're home. you worry. Sometimes you just gotta let it fly. The world is changing right before your eyes. Now I found you. There's no more emptiness inside. When we're hungry, love will keep us alive.
I would die for you, climb the highest mountain, baby. There's nothing I wouldn't do. Now I've found you. There's no more emptiness inside. When we're hungry, love will keep us alive.
I would die. Climb the highest mountain, and baby, there's nothing I wouldn't do. I was
Lere mai o fetat kutu ia. ta umonuia kona utalitali maafana ki taudoro ke tau hoko feohi tamo ki naudoro kona ukelekele eigini. Shout for joy to the Lord, O the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before Him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is good. It is He who made us, and we are His. We are His people, the sheep of His pasture. Enter His gate with thanksgiving and His court with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name. For the Lord is good and His love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. Friends, we are gathered here today in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Delita Balakurufuna and Elizabeth Merebana Venkiso, to surround them with prayer and to share in their joy. Delita, today, and Elizabeth commit their lives to love each other. Let us commit ourselves to love and support them, and to celebrate God's love for us all. The love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us bow our head and pray. Heavenly Father, we gather to celebrate your gift of love and His presence among us. We rejoice that those people have chosen to commit themselves to a life of loving faithfulness to one another. We praise you, Lord, for the ways you have touched our lives with the variety of loving relationships. And we give thanks for Demita and Elizabeth, and for the special love and friendship you have put in their hearts, renewing within us affection and a loving spirit, enrich our lives with the gracious gift of your love, so that we may embrace others with the same love. May our participation in this celebration of love and commitments to give us a new joy and responsiveness to the relationships that we cherish. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. We're going to sing our first hymn, 420 Fa Wanoa Himi. Sikoloe kotela iloto kaleri. Nai fuaha I hena a hili oi eiki. Nai dai koe fafanga pia faito mahaki. Ka koe kātuanga koe faibe o mari.
Thank you.
I'd like to invite you to join me in declaration of candidates. Marriage is a gift of God and a means of grace. In a lifelong union of marriage, we can know the joy of God, in whose image we are made, male and female. Marriage is founded in God's loving nature. In the covenant of love we made with us in Christ, husband and wife, in giving themselves to each other in love, reflect the love of Christ for his church. In Christian marriage, wife and husband are called to live together faithfully, to love each other with respect, gentleness and delight. The companionship and the comfort of marriage enables the full expression of physical love between husband and wife. They share the life of a home and may be entrusted with the gift and care of children. They help to shape a society in which human dignity and happiness may flourish and abound. Marriage is a way of life that all people should honor. It is not to be entered into lightly or selfishly, but responsibly and in the love of God. David and Elizabeth are now to begin this way of life that God has created and Christ has blessed. Therefore, on this, their wedding day, we pray that they may fulfill God's purpose for the whole of their lives. This time, I'd like to invite Micah to read to us the Gospel of Mark, chapter 10, verse 1 to 9.
This reading comes from Mark chapter 10, verse 1 to 9. Jesus then left that place and went into the region of Judea and crossed the Jordan. Again, crowds of people came to him, and as was his custom, he taught them. Some Pharisees came and tested him by asking, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife? What did Moses command you?" He replied. They said, "Moses permitted a man to write a certificate of divorce and send her away. It was because your hearts were hard that Moses wrote you this law," Jesus replied. "But at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, God has joined together, let no one separate." This is the word of the Lord.
This time I'd like to invite Rosie to come and read 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 1 to 13.
Corinthians chapter 1, verse 13. If I speak in the tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give all of my body to hardship that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres.
Thank you, Rosie. David and Elizabeth, it has been an honor for me to share the joy of your wedding day. And I believe God bless you. I believe that is God's gift. And it's God's will for us to be happy. What's happened today? We have seen the love that has been mature between you, and you share that love together. In just a few minutes, you will publicly express your love and pledge yourself to each other for the rest of your life in a sacred, covenant of marriage. We all believe that love we have seen today was formed in the past and through time. It becomes mature and you have started to appreciate each other. There have been an act of thoughtfulness and words of encouragement. You have gained a respect for each other's qualities, strength of the soul, and trustworthiness and kindness. In 1 Corinthians 13, often called this passage the love chapter of the Bible. But the uniqueness of this chapter, because it is not romantic love, but rather it is a behavior we exercise even when we do not feel loved or lovable. Remember, Paul wrote these words to a group of Christians who were in the process of destroying themselves and the church due to inability to get along. And it just reminds you that this message fits in for you today in the last long of your marriage. I can tell you, you will be faced some waves in life, some storms. And that's how important for you to prepare for that day. And don't ignore it. It is part of life. I believe that's why this passage fits in for our wedding passage. Because there will be a time when you are facing some differences. There will be a time that you are going to argue with each other. There will be a time when you are both having some conflicts. This passage is fitting with how to live out your marriage life through the rest of your life. And this is where the Bible teaches about how to live in harmony and hold on to each other when you do not love them. The gospel referred to marriage as a joint of two people to become one flesh. It is the will of God and is formed by God. And it is a divine gift from God. And it's meant to last forever. Listen to Paul's word. Verse 4, he says, love is patient. Love is kind. Sometimes you will be stressed out. Sometimes you will be frustrated. Love is patient and love is kind. Sometimes you might want to give harsh criticism when your spouse does something foolish or hurtful. Love is kind. Love is patient. Second, Paul tells us that love is not careless and boastful. Sometimes we try to make ourselves look better than we really are. We may even criticize your partner to make us feel better about ourselves. Our competitive spirit may get the best of us. And we try to prove that we are better, smarter, and more professional, more talented than your partner. Just selfish behavior in a marriage will prove to be unproductive and even destructive. May I suggest that the alternative that is much more worthwhile and enjoyable be proud of each other. Build each other up. Learn to praise the uniqueness gift of your life's partner. Paul makes advice to avoid arrogance and rudeness. Paul knows that sometimes we treat those we love with less courtesy, even than a stranger. We may take our spouse for granted. Occasionally, we may be rude to them in private. Even worse, we may be rude to them in public. Paul would urge that we strive to treat our spouse with reverence, respect, just like we want him or her to treat. Of all the ideals that Paul holds us before us, this text one may be the hardest. Love does not exist upon its own way. Now, the reader and listener, I'm going to assume that there may be some time your relationship with each other, that one or both of you have insisted or having your own way. Such behavior is present in most relationships. But it is not helpful. Marriage intended to be a journey filled with compromises. If both of you are willing to compromise, if both of you are willing to respond to the wants and needs of others, not just your own, then your marriage will be much more peaceful and protected. Me and mine need to let it go. Changes with us and ours. It's more inclusive, the way that you treat each other. It's not about me, it's about us. Anytime you discuss things in the families, you talk about the language. It's us and ours, not me and mine. Do you listen to me? This is the language that has to change. The language that you live in your family's life. Love is an action, not just words. Our English version says love is kind, but the Greek words translated kind is a verb. And says something closer to love performs acts of kindness and bestows thoughtful words and deep upon others while avoiding retaliation. Paul's next description of love is difficult to follow. He tells us that love is not irritable or resentful. I wonder if there's anyone here who has never been irritable or resentful. In fact, most of us fail to live out this quality of love. Rather than being present, we're sometimes easily irritated and angered. Rather than politely answering a simple question of a spouse, we may respond with a loud or hostile voice. This is not helpful. Too often we become argumentative and defensive. I believe that Paul would argue all of us that when we fail to live up to this ideal, we avoid making excuses for our behavior or simply admit we are wrong. Sorry, I've been in a bad mood today. Let's start over. This is what you need to be happen in your family's life. Paul's model of Christian love may even suggest a strange double standard. When a spouse is irritable, we are to be patient. When we are irritable, we are to ask for forgiveness. But if we live by this advice, there will be a peace in your home. Paul goes on to say that love does not rejoice with wrong, but rejoice in right. Davina and Elizabeth, that means that you should have a strong principle and a sense of justice. You should celebrate both life and success. My prayer for two of you is that you will continue to grow in love. Love for one another. Love for God and love for your neighbor. If you do this, you have a blessed marriage. You have a blessed life. Wow. In Thomas' space. According to Kimberly Payne, it's not an empty space, not a space that separates, but a space that relates, that holds separate entities and things together. In order to have effective understanding of this space in our culture, we must seek first to understand the role of vow in your marriage life. And I want to remind you, in that vow we call it in Tonga a sacred space. The vow between husband and wife. This place where you both form the love that we have seen and witnessed for it today. And I'd like to remind you again, it is not an empty space, nor a space that separates. The space where love has been formed. This vast space where you can both learn to express respect and honor your marriage life. The space sometimes you need to spread the mats and the family tower. And you know that you heard about it. Spread the mats and the family tower. What does that mean? Sometimes there will be a difference in you, in your journey. You both sit down on the mats and talk in a very nice, respecting way. This is how you help make your family have a peaceful, enjoyable life. Remember that. Mary, prepare a mat at home. Whenever you argue, run and get the mat here. We sit down on the mat and we talk and we listen to each other. This is how you bring the joy and harmony into your family's life. And we all want you to enjoy your family's life. Therefore, that you understand the space, the vow. We have a Tongan concept, Tauhi Hotavaha Ngatai. In Tonga, the people plant the Ngatai plants to mark the boundaries of his land from other person's land. Therefore, they both have an obligation and pledge to respect their boundaries. And this relationship has been formed, become a space they both created to respect for each other. And it is important for you to respect it. Plant a Ngatai around your palm tree, and you both respect it. This is exactly what we are doing here. Although that you both become as one entities, but remember you are both different in gender, in characters, in nature, and in your mind. These differences may become a stumbling block for your journey. I hope you take serious about the importance of keeping your relationship healthy all the time. Important to commit to church and enjoy fellowship with the people of faith and be part of the community life. And then community and the family continue to reshape your family's life day by day. And not only that, allow God to reshape your family's life and you will never have a trouble in your families, and you make your families happy every day. May God bless you, and hopefully Devita and Lisbeth, remember the Mass. Have a special Mass at home and avoid that Mass that's your discussion Mass. Whatever's happening in life, whoever you run, get the Mass and spread, and you both sit down and say to each other, well, how about we just keep quiet and listen to each other? And this is where you learn about love, caring, family's life. And I hope this will help you. That guide your change through this lifetime. And I hope God bless you and you enjoy your family life. Even more enjoyable if God gives you some gifts of children. And maybe one day we'll see each other and I will see you. They still hold on to the joy that we all, poor family, have shared today. God bless you. Thank you very much. At this time, we're going to sing our next hymn. It's 610. 610, Oi, Kentala, Pomono, Godemao, Hafanafo. Koko, I mama, Kepoui, Hiki, I made Kemoui. Pomono, Kolo, Kemo, Kutani, Kato, Famoni, Fopapao. Father, I hate you. Strengthen us, deepen our love for one another, and renew our lives from Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. This is the declaration of intent. Demeter and Elizabeth, I ask you now to declare your intent by responding to these questions. Do you both believe that God has blessed you and guided you and now called into marriage?
I do.
Demeter, will you give yourself to Elizabeth to be her husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her and comfort her, and honor and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Elizabeth, will you give yourself to Demeter to be his wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him and comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsake him or others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
This time I'd like to invite the parents please to come forward to affirm your support for Demeter. Miriami, Elamenda, Soane and Josefina. Mofia Maria, Tabaki, and Mari, Bobo and Maria, their Vita, from the list of D. Pegemo, Fapa Pau, the Motoponi, Ginawa, Ian and the North of Mari. Thank you. Please be seated. This is the time. You had to change your lives. There we go.
I, Demeter Valahulupuna, take you, Elizabeth Mele Pana Belkiso, to be my wife. I declare that I will love you just as God loves us. That is, as the husband was called to love their wives, as Jesus loved the church, so will I love you. I will love you from morning till night, from start to end. I will lay my life down for you. For as long as we shall live, I will fight for us. As the sermon said, love hopes all things, believes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. And this I declare before you and everyone else, that I will never fail us. That I will love us with a covenantal love. The love that Jesus, that our Father, our Heavenly Father, made with Abraham, that he will be our God and we will be his people. So you, Mele, will be my wife and I will be your husband. And this I solemnly vow.
I, Elizabeth Mele Vaga Velkiso, take you, Demeter Valahulupuna, according to God's will, to be my husband. I will love you. I will share my life with you. All I have, I give to you. All I am, I give to you. I will serve alongside you, God's purpose for us. I will follow your lead. This is my solemn vow.
This is a time of exchange and giving of rings. But let's pray together. Father, we pray that we have received this gift. May the Holy Spirit bless this gift. When David and Elizabeth exchanged this ring together, and they made their vows to each other, may this ring remind them the covenant they have formed today. May the Holy Spirit use this ring to remind them every day it's a covenant in their life, their marriage must live forever. Amen. Elizabeth, I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
It's a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
And of the vows which we have made today.
And of the vows which we have made today.
Say this, Miss Debita. Debita.
Debita.
Look at Debita. I receive this ring.
I receive this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
In the vows which we have made today.
In the vows of which we have made today.
Okay. Here we are. Hold his hand. Debita.
Debita,
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
It's a sign of our marriage.
And a sign of our marriage.
And the vows which we have made today.
And the vows which you have made today.
Say, Elizabeth.
Elizabeth.
I receive this ring.
I receive this ring.
It's a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
And of the vows which we have made today.
And of the vows which we have made today.
Before God in the presence of us all, Debita Bahufuna Elizabeth Melipangafuna made their solemn vows. They confirmed their marriage by joining of hands and by giving and receiving of rings. In the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit, I therefore proclaim they are now a husband and wife. Those whom God had joined together, no one must separate. Moving on. So, you are Elizabeth Funena, let us bless your marriage. The riches of God's grace be upon you, that you may live together in faith and love, and receive the blessing of eternal life. May the Almighty God, who created you, redeem you and guide you, bless you now and always. Amen. This is a time for our Holy Communion, and I'd like to invite the parents come forward, and we all do together the Holy Communion. Please come forward. house today. Now we stand in a divine table of Jesus Christ. He invites you to come. This is the new covenant that sealed the vow that you had made today. Jesus said, come as you are. We come to this table not because we are holy, but because we are sinners. We come to this table not because we are strong, but because we are weak. As I remind you, we do not deserve this table. Even to pick up the crumbs falling from the table of the Lord. But Jesus did it anyway. He invites you, come as you are. Your parents is behind you to support you. And we all stand together with the families here. You know that love of God never ends. It's a symbol for your marriage. To remind you that someone laid down his life for you. His name, Jesus Christ. He died. So for you and me. Let's just bow and pray. Loving God, we invite the Holy Spirit to bless this bread and wine. As we're ready to partake and share this bread and wine, remind us your body and your blood were shed because of our sins. Father, bless this. Whenever we take the bread and drink the wine, to remind us the grace of God and your love for us. In Jesus we pray. Amen. On the night when he was betrayed, Jesus took the bread. And he shared with the disciples and said, this is my body, which is given for you. Eat from this all of you. It's a memory. It's a memory of Jesus Christ. After the supper, Jesus took the cup. This is the blood of the new covenant. Drink from this all of you in the memory of me. Elizabeth, Davida, and her family, this is a gift of God for you now. Let's just open our heart to accept that Jesus invited you to come and we eat together and drink together from his body and his blood. Jesus took the bread and he broke it. This is the symbol of the brokenness that he went through. Holes in his body, wounded because of our iniquities. Christ. He sold his love for you and me. This is the bread, the symbol. This is the blood of the new covenant, was shed on the cross. For you, the blood was dripping down from the cross to the ground. Remind us that Jesus Christ, we died together with Adam. Now we live together with Christ. This is the new covenant.
Please be seated and prepare to sign.
for.
Generations and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations. Children, may his presence go before.
Let us bow our head and pray. Gracious God, our hearts are filled with great tenderness on this day, the wedding day of the leader Elizabeth. We come before you, pledging their lives and their hearts to one another. Grant that they may be ever true and loving, living together in such a way as to never bring heartbreak into their marriage. Temper their heart with kindness and help them to be sweethearts, helpmates, friends and guides, and together may they meet the cares and problems of life more bravely. May their home truly be a place of love and harmony where your spirit is ever present. Bless their wedding day, we pray, and walk beside them for all their lives together. Amen. Just face to the family. I'll just give our hands. God bless you. Now we all be celebrated.
This is a celebration. These songs up top were meant to be easy so we could sing them together. Psalms 118 says, "This is a day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." Do you have joy? Let me hear you.
And bless his name. Every second, every minute, every hour that I'm in it, I will
always remember
this
is the day the Lord has made.
Every second, every minute, every hour that I'm in it, oh, I will
always remember
this is
the day the Lord has made.
Every second, every minute, every hour that I'm in.
There was
was the moment that I spent just loving you. Thing that ever happened to me.